Hi guys, Clive here from CMC Hobbies again. Today we just want to show you the correct way to install a C-clip into a piston so that we don't have failures or damaged C-clips. What I've got here is two C-clips. There's a perfectly round one. This is one that's been damaged. And I'm going to show you how these damage very easily. What you don't want to do is be grabbing a pair of pliers, squashing them at the open end like this to try and get them in. Because what happens is you end up with a kink, even if it's more subtle than this. That circlip's going to lose tension, and when the motor's running, it's going to come out the motor, go through the motor, and damage the motor. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a small flat screwdriver to try and tease it round. When we're inserting it, we're going to try and tease this in a circular fashion, so we're stretching it round and putting even pressure all the way around that ring, not to damage it. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to take the C-clip, I'm going to install it, take the open end, and try and get that end into that groove like that. Press it in lightly, make sure it's on the groove properly. I'm going to hold it in place. Then I'm going to take my thumb, I'm going to put my thumb on the back of it here. And while I'm teasing it round with the screwdriver, I'm actually going to be pressing very hard with my thumb to push it down into that groove. Okay, we don't just want to use a screwdriver to bend it. Also, obviously be very careful with the screwdriver. We don't want to put any gouge marks or any marks of any sort on the piston. So we're going to slowly start to tease it round. And with my thumb, I'm pushing all the time. Push a little bit harder, and there we go, not quite, try again. Sometimes they can be a little bit tricky to get in, if we haven't got it quite right. There we go, that's gone nicely, and listen for the click when it goes in. There's my first click. Now I'm going to take the screwdriver, just gently push it down, and you'll hear that click into place. Once it's in place, I've got a sharp scribe. I just want to take that scribe and I rotate it in the groove. Two reasons. By being able to rotate in the groove, we know it's seated nicely in that groove. And secondly, I just want to ensure that the open end of the groove is either sitting at the 6 o'clock or the 12 o'clock position. We don't want to leave the ring groove sitting at either side. And the reason for that is just the G-forces during the motor. When the motor is running, it's the correct place to have it. Okay guys, thanks very much for watching. Lastly, I'd just like to thank GP Engines for the ongoing support, and we're looking forward to a good competition season this year.